When people think of Pasadena, they think of money, they think of affluence, but really there are many corners of the city where people are struggling, where people who live in Pasadena who can't make ends meet. They work here, but they struggle to find housing that they can afford. They struggle to feed their families.
There's need everywhere you look in Southern California. It's just the constant sight of homeless people camping on the streets. It's a constant reminder. One day I was coming down from Altadena and I saw probably a 75-year-old woman passed out in the bushes underneath the bridge. I said, you know, something needs to be done. Something needs to be done. And if I can, whatever I can do to help prevent that, to get that poor woman into a shelter, into a home, well, I want to try to do that.
When Captain Terry and Colonel Kyle approached me to co-chair this campaign, I immediately said yes. And as I was thinking about it later during the day and that night, I thought, I can't do this. I have no knowledge of how to do this. So I was on my way down here early one morning to tell Terry that I had changed my mind. I drove by the food pantry door and I saw a line of people waiting. And the door wasn't even going to open for 2 hours for their breakfast, and they were already in line waiting. And once I saw that, I knew I had to do this, and I had to make a difference.
At the northeast corner of our facility, we have a building that's a two-story building, mid-century office structure that is in a dilapidated state. We serve people from little crevices, little offices. They're like caves, really. We are looking at building a facility that is 4 stories high. The first floor, we want to create a shopping style experience. We call it client choice. Client choice, instead of pre-packing a box, we give people a shopping cart. They walk around like they're in a grocery store, picking foods that are culturally relevant, foods that their family can cook, but also if they have dietary needs, if they have allergies and so forth, they can pick foods that work well for them. Most of the foods that are given at food banks are thrown away or returned because most people don't know what to do with those foods. But when they are choosing, they have the dignity of making a choice, but they also pick things that are relevant to them. Beyond food, there'll be case management, there'll be opportunities for people to attend life skills classes, budgeting, parenting, and grooming, and so forth. All of that is important to help families stay in their homes. It is cheaper to keep the families in the homes than to try and find housing for them. But for those who are unfortunate to have a struggle to find affordable housing in our area, then second to fourth floor would be what we call permanent supportive housing. These are single room occupancy rooms where individuals living in our community who are working can come and stay. The word permanent meaning they can stay as long as they want. Supportive is that they are supportive services we are providing. We are looking at providing a place for 65 units. And 14 of those will be for our veterans.
Craig and I picked the Salvation Army to get involved with because we know that when we give them money, they do good with the money. They are trustworthy. They've been doing this for so many years and they are 100% non-discriminatory. They will take anybody in who is in need. And I know that, I've seen it, we've witnessed it on many occasions.
The Salvation Army is very thrifty with the dollar. 87 cents of every dollar goes to helping the people in need directly. It doesn't go to administration, it doesn't go to salaries, it doesn't go to facilities. No, 87 cents out of every dollar goes to the person in need. We can't help as many people as we'd like here in Pasadena because we just don't have the facilities. So the Hope Center will correct that. It is estimated that we will be able to help twice as many people with the new facility than what we have now. And this will help people that are in need to not become homeless. Maybe those that are right on the edge. It'll provide food and counseling and services that can, like I say, prevent someone from becoming homeless, or if someone already is, it will help them get well and not need so much in the way of assistance in the future.
Craig and I have chosen to give sacrificially to this program because we know the impact of the social services that will be provided. The food pantry for food-challenged families and food-challenged kids, the backpack program, the Dress for Success. Those are all so important, keeping kids' morale up and their self-esteem, and teaching them at the same time to give back to their community when they're able to give back.
I believe that today, if we all pull our resources together, we'll be able to build this facility. Never in my time as a Salvation Army officer, which is almost 15 years and 20 years in direct ministry, have I seen so many things come together as they have this particular year. There's funding from federal, state, county, and city, funds directed towards ending homelessness. I've never seen the opportunities we are seeing today where their community members were saying, we have to do something. I've never seen an opportunity like this where we have a building that's ready for use and we can maximize its use by putting together these two programs, a food bank, a state-of-the-art food bank, and permanent supportive housing. In Africa, I'm African, and in Africa, we often heard as I was growing up that if you want to go somewhere, go alone. But if you want to go far, go with others. We want to give you an opportunity to participate in changing lives in Pasadena by contributing to this project. I believe that when we meet our goals, we'll all be so pleased to have a state-of-the-art facility in our own community addressing the problem of homelessness and the struggles that families face.